Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We're still here on Urban Television, and tonight we're hosting Uganda Christian University, the Guild Presidential Debate 2021, where the Electoral Commission vetted for three candidates. Two of them are running for the post in Mukono campus, and one candidate from Kampala campus. It's about that time we listen to some of the opinions from the different students at the main campus, that is in Mukono, and find out some of the key issues they feel like their next Guild President should be putting their priorities on right now.
You're watching
My name is Kalle Ruth Opra, pursuing a Bachelor of Laws. I'm in my fourth year at Uganda Christian University.
My name is Daniel Okiror Musenguzi, first year doing law here at Uganda Christian University, Mukono.
Hi viewers, I'm Craig Agawa. I'm a fourth year law student at Uganda Christian University.
Hello, my name is Hope Odeke. I'm currently pursuing a Bachelor of Laws at Uganda Christian University, and I'm in my fourth year.
What I would like for my next Guild President to work on a few things. First of all, I think it is important that my Guild President, if I vote you in power, you should work on looking at how we can improve from, you know, the casual stuff that we've been doing and shift everything we've been doing and make it an online platform kind of thing. We do not want to be that kind of university where we are looked at as old-fashioned, because times are changing and we need to shift with the times. So I think we should work on making sure that everything goes online. We need to go e, because that's what the world is right now.
One of the things that I would love a next Guild President to do for us as a student community is to work hand in hand with people that are in a position to communicate to all spheres of the country, to our students, concerning our academic life, because that is the main reason as to why we're in school. So the Guild President, in coordination with his team, should be able to ease communication mechanisms to all students in different areas of the country.
I think I'd love to see a president, a Guild President, that is highly that focuses more on rationale than emotion, and finds ways to actively solve disparities and situations within the school community. I mean, they may be ranging from financial implications and balancing relations between the administration and the students' body.
Personally, I would love for him to negotiate with the student board on better student policies, like policies that affect us in regards to tuition, accommodation, lectures. If you can really compile those 3 points into one and see a way how to levy them for us for the betterment of the students in Uganda Christian University, that will be very, very good for us.
Okay, so for example, the first thing, I think we need to work on having exams online, because the practice has been good, you've seen it, and every student was really appreciative. So I think we need to work on that, for example. Second of all, the Guild government that has just left power has introduced e-voting, so you need to maintain that. I think it is a good initiative, so you need to work on that as well.
Okay, one of the things that I would like a student Guild President to be able to do alongside his team is to find creative mechanisms to help students facing financial difficulties, considering the fact that the COVID pandemic has affected each and every person in Uganda. So therefore, I would definitely encourage the team to find ways in which they can actually help students.
With accommodation, it is a very small room where we are forced to stay four people in one small room. I would like for us to be at least two, for one person to be on either side. With the corona pandemic and all other diseases that are social diseases that are concerned, I would like for that to be worked upon.
You're watching.
All right, those are some of the opinions coming in from students of UCU, and of course, there's some of the key areas they feel like their next real president should take priority of. And of course, since we have the candidates in the house right now, let's find out some of the plans in accordance to what the students are saying. Starting with Honorable Jim Patrick, what do you plan to do for UCU to take it to the next level in case you're voted into power?
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. My dear comrades, I come to you with a vision a vision to create a strong, confident, united students' body with a functional working relationship with the administration and the different stakeholders. We are faced by very many challenges, but as the Guild, we need to find ways to solve these challenges within our mandate, within our limits, our available resources. As a student's body, how do we work together to solve these challenges? I will start with the tuition challenges. I must commend the current Guild for starting up the annual run, which realized so much money to help students with tuition problems. And I believe when we are voted into power, because I won't be alone, when you vote me, you have voted a team. It means we shall ensure this run continues because it has helped us raise tuition for students.
All right, thank you very much. Yes, continue.
The next way, we need to encourage solidarity funds. I am an engineer, and we have a solidarity fund called Engineer for Engineer, and very many engineers have benefited from it. This is a fund that any student, any engineer can contribute to year after year, throughout the year, anytime, whether the run is there or not. This student can contribute whenever they get what to contribute. Why don't we encourage other faculties, the lawyers, social works, the education faculty? Why can't you adopt the same strategy? As the Guild fights to increase the Guild fund, you are being helped from within your faculty. You as a faculty, you are helping your friends, your colleagues to have a better experience. The second, security. I must commend the university for trying to improve security in and around. But very many students are in hostels. We as a Guild, what do we do to ensure these hostels are safe for our students? Because security is a priority for our students. Advocating. We must advocate to hostel owners to encourage them to provide security lights or cameras or both. Examples of Kronos, Skycourts, Bethany, they all have these things, security lights, cameras. Why can't other hostels, through the Guild, advocating for these things, install these simple things that will ensure security of our students? Mental health awareness. We have realized this is an area that has been left out year after year. But the COVID pandemic has hinted it, that this is an area we need to strictly and vividly pay attention to. But how do we do it as the Guild? How do we ensure our students, our staff, and all the people that affect our students' well-being at school have upright mental health? First of all, we need to sensitize the students on the availability of the Ruth Nkoyoyo Wellness Center, a center that provides all possible ways to solve mental health problems. We don't need to wait for adverse effects to happen for us to pay attention to this sector. Prevention is better than cure. Therefore, I believe if we continue encouraging students, those who don't know that you can go and learn as a volunteer, 1 month, a short course, and you get a certificate as a peer guidance and counselor, you can get that certificate, and in that way, we are trying to move the service from the Ruth Nkoyoyo Center, where it's far from the students, to within the student's body, because I believe a student can trust another student better. And I believe together we can do better. I bring you hope. I bring you confidence. I bring you unity.
And of course, that is Honorable Jim Patrick Waswa. Now, we want to listen to Honorable Agaba Kenneth Amponda, still from the main campus, Mukono. How different are your plans for UCU 2020-2021?
Thank you so much, Mr. Moderator. As I stated before, my slogan states, building the bridge to the new normal. With the invasion of COVID-19 pandemic, Uganda Christian University has embedded more on online education than physical education. The largest percentage of Uganda Christian University students are offering online education compared to those at the institution right now physically. So as the incoming Guild leadership headed by Agaba Kenneth Amponda. We are saying we have identified the challenges and we have found the solutions for our brothers and sisters having challenges pursuing this new normal. First and foremost, we have had the first years that are on board this year. And Mr. Moderator, for more of your information, we have more than 300 students in almost each faculty as first years. And now, with the education system that we're having at Uganda Christian University, which is online education, these students have just come from high school, they have just been embedded into the university setting, and we are saying there is lack of proper sensitization of these students on how best they can use these services. For more of your information, even the second years, the third years, the fourth years are finding challenges in using these systems.
Should we say that the online system of, you know, education right now in UCU is not extremely effective as we are thought out here?
No, Mr. Modulator, thank you so much. But I would like to address our minds to the fact that within the transition to the new normal, we face challenges. And as leaders, we are there to find solutions to these challenges. That's why I'm here as Agaba Kenneth Amponda, aspiring for the position of Guild President. We have a point on education policy. We have a point on inclusion of students in policy making and decision making. We have a point on finance. And on the beauty part of it, Mr. Modulator, I'm going to indulge more on education, student inclusion, and finance. On the education part of it, we are saying, as students, we are facing a lot of challenges in this online education. First and foremost, the survey that was made to ensure that we go online, it states that 95% of Uganda Christian University students can offer online education. This survey is based on the fact that you have a smartphone, I have a gadget, and we can access Wi-Fi within the institution. But the time has changed. The time has changed in a way that these students now are in different parts of this nation. And in different parts of this nation, we are facing different challenges. For example, a student deep in Kamalameido, a student deep in Alua, access to electricity to charge these gadgets itself is a problem. Data purchasing is a problem. The parents are paying tuition vis-a-vis also catering for the data. It's a challenge. You find to charge a gadget, you first move a distance, and charging is 1,000. So as the incoming leadership, we are saying we can find a solution, and we provide here solutions. We are saying for the students that cannot manage being online all the time, we are going to advocate for audio recording and video recording. The lecturers can always record these video lectures and post them on the platform of the institution so that this student who cannot afford being online all the time can come and access that audio or video at any time.
Video and audio recording. Before maybe to just cut you a little bit, Mr. Jim Patrick, Honorable Jim Patrick, do you agree that video and audio recording will be effective?
First of all, I'd like to provide some piece of information. Some courses have already adopted the system and have already started recording, but I believe we have inclusive progress. I believe we need to move with a trend. Technology is always good for us. Therefore, I commend the university for trying to provide this system for our students to not only complete their studies in time, but also help them acquire the skills even during this pandemic.
All right,
because other
you.
Countries are already far.
Yes, Honorable Aga, please continue.
And on the same point of online education, Mr. Moderator, for more of your information, Uganda Christian University is the first university within the nation that has tried and managed to offer online services. And we did the examinations, take homes via online. And we succeeded. And we are saying, why don't we use the same dioceses that we are using during that time? For example, Uganda Christian University, we have a partnership as a Christian university founded on the Anglican Church. We have access to every diocese within the nation. So for those students that cannot manage pursuing online services or online education, why don't we send these materials to those different dioceses so that they can pick them from there, attempt and read. Then in the future, when we have also examinations, we do the same thing. We manage to do it within 1 month. We can do better within 3 months of the semester. On student inclusion in policy and decision making, we are saying for so long as Uganda Christian University students, we have had that we have felt the gap that we are not involved in decision making of the university, and also the policies that are formulated are just embedded on us as students, but we have no say and we have no part in the formulation of these policies as partners. But as the incoming guild leadership, we are saying we have a solution to this. We are coming to provide and build a bridge to the new normal. The new normal is to the effect that most of the students are off the campus. And as the incoming leadership, we are saying, we want to involve and make sure that every student can have a participation in decision-making and policy-making. And this is how we intend to achieve it. We have the institutions within the university that have been there for so long, and we have not been making use of them. We have the residential assistant institution. We have the class representative institution. We have the presence of different academic associations within the university. And I believe if we work hand in hand as the guild leadership with these associations, with these class representatives, we can have student-based ideas. For example, Mr. Moderator, we want to have scenarios where we invite the class representative association cabinet to come before the floor of parliament and tell us the situation within those students in different classes, to tell us the challenges they are facing. These are the people that know the students that lack tuition. These are the people that know the students that do not have, let's say, $1 million a day. These are the people that know the students that have lost their beloved ones. And we are saying, as the incoming guild leadership, we are going to work hand in hand with these people to make sure that we provide student-centered leadership and resolutions. We have also a point on finance. The finance bit of it, we would like to appreciate the current guild government for having an innovative idea of guild run. But we are saying, as in the incoming guild leadership, we are going to make sure that we spice this guild run. We are going to make sure that we modernize this guild run. We are aiming at collecting large sums of amounts of money to make sure that we help out our fellow brothers and sisters that are having tuition challenges. And this is how we intend to achieve this. We are saying we are going to partner more with the private sector to make sure that we increase our base of the money. How? The last guild run that we had was a success. But now, the one we are bringing to you, my brothers and sisters, it's more of a success than the one we had before. We are saying we are going to invite our fellow universities to come and participate. We have a scenario whereby we have invited Makerere University students, we have invited Chambogo University students, and also other universities. When they come and participate, this is the increment in money. We're also saying private companies provide cash. We have had scenarios whereby we have been bringing, let's say, different political personnel, and they promise 100 million shillings, but they give us 20 million shillings in cash. But for us, we are saying, with the private sector, where there is no much of bureaucracy, these people, when they promise 100 million shillings, they will give us 100 million shillings. And at the end of the day, the student needs will be catered for within a short period of time, within my term of administration. For more of your information, Mr. Moderator, the last guild run that we had, we may have collected more than 100 million shillings, but the cash was not more than 50 million shillings. So we are saying, as the incoming guild government, when we embed more with the private partnership, we believe the collection of this amount of money is going to be in cash basis. And after having it in cash basis, my brothers and sisters, I assure you, the tuition challenge is going to be solved. I come here to build a bridge to the new normal.
All right, thank you so much, Honorable Agaba. And of course, our social media people have just put up a post right now on Facebook. The handle is at Urban Television. If you want to comment, if you want to ask a question to any of the candidates in the house, feel free to go down there. It's at Urban Television. You'll find a post where it has the three candidates in the house right now. According to the first few messages that are coming through, I see Hanif saying, salute to Mr. Amponda, the phenomenon. Rhoda Grace says, in love with Fabe. Then I have somebody called Felix says, Jim for Guild. All right, some other time we hear from the only candidate from Kampala campus, and of course that is Honorable Namujehe. I hope I pronounce it right. Yep, Namujehe Fabe Desire. So you are the only standing contestant. Kampala campus is watching. What should they expect from your government?
Ensure that we notify that the Kampala campus is quite a different campus, in that the challenges they experience most times may not necessarily be so much similar to the ones of Mukono campus. Why? most of the students in Kampala campus are a kind of society whereby they go to work and come and study. That's why we have the evening students at Kampala campus. That is why we have most of the students advocating for the fact that if it's day school, it should stop at 5, so they can go and earn a living and pay their tuition, or some advocating for the fact that if it's evening school, it should be really evening school. Now the students we're trying to cater for in this kind of online study. With that, again, I'm saying that Kampala campus students are students that are very innovative and creative, in that they're studying with people that are of great influence, that keep challenging them with different levels of development. That is the environment at Kampala campus. A legacy that is not easily broken by anybody that just stands for any position. As a result, I am coming in for the following issues. My agenda has three main points: accessibility, development, and accountability. I desire that everybody joins me in believing in this, in that by saying that accessibility, first of all, in an angle of education, having explained this, the kind of people that are in Kampala campus, the community of Kampala campus, that means the solutions are supposed to be a little diverse, a little broad in dealing with such people. What am I saying? Kampala campus students are a kind of students whereby if there is information that they need to get, it needs to be provided quickly, effectively, and in a way that they would not strain so much, because most of their day is allocated to earning a living so that they can be able to avail the tuition for the lecturers to keep on teaching. So it shall be a disservice if they go on and begin to struggle to seek the information after struggling to get the education, the money to be able to pay for their tuition or for their services at UCU Kampala campus. As a result, I am saying that in our time of service at Kampala campus, this is going to come to an end. We are going to have a leadership where people are very, very assertive, where people are keen to offer a service to the community, keen to offer a service to the different challenges that the students are facing very quickly and with too much effect. I'll give a very simple scenario of the online study. We should be able to understand the online study so broadly in the point that students are actually being denied a chance, some of them, to get back to hostels. You get? Not because the parents are not aware of the fact that they need to be in hostels, but because the economic standards have actually changed. That means some are still in Butaleja, some are still in Kasese, some are still as far as you may not know how. That means some are staying with very hard and complicated family members, some are staying with siblings that they have to nappy every time. These are the kind of people now we are dealing with. People that are in a society whereby we do not want to just look back and think for them and think that the way they would have been physically is how they are today. That is something that we need to put into consideration. As a result, I would also seek that recorded lectures should really be considered. I would seek that they should put into consideration the fact that it may not be so efficient to roll call, because roll call may actually do a disservice. Why may it do a disservice? It's a good thing to ensure that students are in line with education, but it's another thing to expect them to be sent to serve a different to be sent to get water from a well at that point, and that's a time when a very important point is being passed on by the lecturer. Are they going to be disobedient to the family members? Are they going to be disobedient to the employers who they are working for to earn a living? These are the kind of people we are trying to deal with. I am going to ensure that when I'm in power, that we try to advocate for these kinds of services, for an understanding that as they look for their tuition, as they look for the time to be able to attend these classes, let them try to understand the students that they are dealing with. Let them try to understand that as some are being released to get back to campus to read to read in the libraries, some are unable to read in the library. Some are unable to access the hard copy books. What are we going to do for such students that are unable to have a point of reading a textbook, yet in the examinations, yet in the different courseworks? They need these kinds of authorities. What is their solution? I am seeking that in such cases, we shall advocate that the administration is very quick to work hand in hand with the lecturers to ensure that there is online information. Textbooks are brought out in an online manner so that the students can be able to access such information, and the education shall be very efficient. We recommend UCU for the online education, but we want them to also be able to notify themselves that the students also need the different textbooks, the different ways, hard copy, the different soft copy textbooks that they could have been referring to if it was a hard copy make. And as a result, I will ensure that with the Minister of Education, I really want to say that Minister of Education is going to work in my government. She or he is going to work. There is no sleep because students need education that is very efficient. So as a result of that, there is just no way we can sit back and allow them go and present themselves outside because they went through online education and they can't present a point because they just read through PDFs, through soft copy, through very small detailed information. They need to get information that is conk and that is original. I'll ensure that we'd work on this so well. Accessibility to things like sports opportunities. Kampala campus is a place whereby our geographical area is quite limited because, of course, they are building our campus that we can't wait to enter. We are so excited for it. But for now, there's a kind of student that is passing through Kampala campus that, to a large extent, is not having an opportunity to exercise their talent, to implement the God-given talent within them. There are people that are basketballers in Kampala campus. There are very great people that are footballers in Kampala campus. There are people that are volleyballers in Kampala campus. Will they fail to be able to bring out these talents out of them simply because they are in Kampala campus? Now, we are going to enter into an understanding with the university that they should also cater for such students because our theme is very clear, a complete education for a complete person. And students of Kampala campus need that complete education. And that's what I'm going to advocate for. Any student is interested in having a different kind of talent built up should be able to be provided for a platform that talent can be built without too much constraint. This will bring pride to the UCU community. I'll talk about the area of development briefly. Development is so broad, but in my time of service, there will be other voluntary bodies that will come up to ensure that the standards of living of the students in Kampala campus are made better. How? Kampala campus students, as I earlier on explained, are a kind of people that are very innovative, very creative, looking at a brighter future, minus just being at Kampala campus for the different years they may be there. But think about issues like entrepreneurship councils, whereby students that are interested in attaining any entrepreneurship skill can be able to attain this. This shall help them in their outside living. We're not looking at making them only have the outside education. No, there should be students that in case their life is so tough, what is the alternative? Can they have those platforms, indeed a complete education for a complete person? If a student says, I am strained, I have my books here, but I'm failing with tuition, and then you ask them, any skill? No, what a challenge. So in our government, we shall try to ensure that those services are there. The students shall be told to attend these services, and we shall encourage them to for the betterment of themselves. Secondly, we shall look at issues like tuition council. Tuition council is a council that shall also think so deeply as to how to enable students increase on their rate of help when it comes to tuition time. It's absurd that when you have a government and it's only the Minister of Education thinking about the tuition, it gets a little demanding. That's why at some point they're failing in some other duties because they have tuition, they have follow-up lecturers. Let us bring up a tuition council whereby these people will think beyond what one person could have thought to ensure that students are aided with tuition in different ways. It may be through competitions. It may be through scholarships. It may be through a lot of things. Kampala campus people, we have a lot to achieve through our campus. We have a lot. We are in Kampala. We are next to different bodies. We are so privileged and so blessed. I bring you a regime. I bring you a time of service. I bring you a time of leadership that is going to be full of all-round impact. Let it be economic, let it be academic, let it be social, let it be self-esteem, let it be all through. We are going to work together. Thank you so much.
All right, thank you very much, Honorable Desire, of course, the only standing candidate from Kampala campus. I know many of the students from Kampala campus are watching. A number of questions have been raised from disunity among these campuses, to term limits and so forth. And of course, when we come back, we shall dive into some of your questions. But for the meantime, let's take a breather. And of course, in case you just joined us, this is the Guild Presidential Debate, Uganda Christian University 2020-2021, where the Electoral Commission vetted for 3 candidates, 2 running for the Guild post from the main campus in Mukono, and 1 candidate from Kampala campus. See you in a bit.
You're watching. It's